24 DIMSEC scandals that CNN has failed to report on, let's remind them. If you thought there was a lot of groping going on in Hollywood, then you haven't seen anything yet. There's a list of 24 sex scandals perpetrated by Democrats, and it seems like CNN isn't doing their best journalistic work to cover them all equally. Sure, you might see a headline or two about Al Franken supposedly groping a model's breasts in her sleep, or perhaps you'll see a quick John Conyers accusation on his alleged sexual harassment, but are they covering the Democratic accusations as fairly as others? Or is CNN biased towards that and wishes to graze over the incidents while focusing more on any Republican candidate for a sexually influenced crime? The list of Hollywood accusations runs almost as long as the credits at the end of any movie, but here's a list of 24 Democrats involved in sexually related scandals, and I'm not so sure CNN is doing their part to inform the public. It's a true shame that major mainstream news sources have gone full partisan, because now the public lacks true news and honest reporting. Good thing I'm here to fix that. Items in bold are quoted from American News Hub, who did an excellent job compiling this list. 1. Four new women accuse Bill Clinton of sexual assault. November 20, 2017. Former President Bill Clinton was accused of multiple incidents by four women. We already know about his lust for using an intern to hold his cigar and how he may have ruined her dress with some bodily fluids. What's up with the other accusations? Daily Mail ran this story. 2. Congresswoman accuses Democrat former Congressman Bob Filner of sexually assaulting her. November 21, 2017. According to the Huffington Post, Rep. Diana DeGette, Democrat Colorado, accused former Congressman Bob Filner of trying to pin her in an elevator and forcibly kiss her. The Huffington Post ran this? Shocking. They're about as leftist as one could get, and it's a breath of fresh air to see that they would run a story against a Democrat. I still think the HuffPost horrible site filled with virtue signalers, Black Lives Matter enthusiasts, and gender study liberals and feminists, but that's just my opinion. 3. California Democrat Raul Bocanegra resigns leadership position and won't seek re-election over sexual allegations. November 20, 2017. The Los Angeles Times reported that California Democratic Assemblyman Raul Bocanegra said he would suspend his campaign and not seek re-election in the face that a story would be dropping about six women accusing him of sexual harassment. Not seeking re-election smells like guilt to me. 4. Democrat congressional candidate from New Mexico David Ilkhan was arrested for stalking in New Mexico. November 13, 2017. According to the Washington Free Beacon, Ilkhan was arrested after sending a woman persistent messages, including of his genitals, telling her he loved her and suggesting he was watching her. Hasn't anyone learned from Anthony Weiner that we don't send private pics anymore? When you're a politician, the last thing you do is send some chick a picture of your penis and corny messages like you're some desperate chump who can't get a woman. If a woman wants to see it, then she needs to see it in person. Sending pictures of your privates will only bite you on the rear end later. Take it from the king of private pics, Mr. Anthony Weiner himself. Don't do it. But did CNN run the story and show the pics? Doubt it. 5. 10 women accuse Colorado Democratic lawmaker Steve Lebzok of sexual harassment. November 10, 2017. CBS Denver reports that the 10 women include a legislative aide who harassed her at a bar. 10 women is a lot. Are the accusations true? Did CNN run the story and ask every accuser, and do the stories match up? One woman is a lot, but when 10 say it, then you have to wonder. 6. Colorado Democratic House Speaker Crescenta Duran accused of covering up sexual allegations against Democrat Steve Lebzok. November 14, 2017. According to the Denver Post, Colorado's top Democratic lawmaker is under fire for how she handled a colleague's sexual harassment complaint against a member of their party, and now faces calls for an independent investigation. I bet women are thrilled to hear about a woman hiding sexual allegations. Was she in on it? What was her reward for covering up the possible crimes? What did CNN have to say about it? 7. Minnesota Democratic lawmaker Dan Schoen resigns over sexual harassment allegations. November 21, 2017. The Min Post reported that two women accused Schoen of sexually harassing them. One was a former DFL candidate for House who alleged that he grabbed her buttocks, telling her she had a good door-knocking ass. What exactly is a door-knocking ass? I have not ever heard of that before. I know a good one when I see it, and that's not something I've ever referred to one as. Men can't say they don't look, because we do. Everyone looks. However, looking and committing sexual harassment is a huge difference. Everyone looks at each other in one way or another, but that does not warrant any type of grabbing. You can look at the merchandise, but you can't touch it.